a tutorial on creating a histogram on a TI-83. 83 plus is what I'm going to do. Same on an 83 or an 84. Similar on other versions. So to create a histogram, step one is to enter your data. Maybe enter data into a list. And I can write C entering data video. I made another video on how to enter data just because I didn't want the start of every single video to be me entering data because it kind of takes a little while. But the gist of it is hit stat, go into edit, and put in all your values. So I already put in all my values here in L1. It's supposed to be a bunch of GPAs, so I kind of float through and you can see I got 18 observations of various grade point averages. So they're all between 0 and 4. Just kind of pick some numbers at random so I'd have data in there. Step two is you need to tell your calculator to create a histogram. So the way you do that, again, you don't have to exit out of this list or anything. You can do this from any screen on your calculator, is you want to go under stat plot. So I'll say under stat plot. And the way you get to stat plots is you hit second. And then y equals. Because as you notice above this y equals key, it says stat plot. Anyways, I'm going to hit second, y equals, brings up all my plots. Maybe second, y equals, then I guess, well, I'm not going to put it there. Then you want to go into the first, go into one of them. So I'll go into the first one here. It's a good idea to have everything off except for the one you're using. So if you have others that are on, you might want to go into them by highlighting that number and then going into it and turning it off. I'll show you how to turn it off when I go into one of them. If you leave others on, it can show several at the same time, or even more problematic is if you're trying to make one that requires data that you haven't put in yet, it can give you a domain error and it won't show any of your stat plots. Anyways, what I'm trying to say is turn all the rest of them off and then go into one of them. So I can reference three different plots in here. We're just going to stay under the first one. So maybe, well, I guess this is still go into one of them. Highlight on. Maybe turn on. So note off is selected, but on is where my cursor is. If I hit enter, now on is selected. If it were on and I wanted to turn it off, just go highlight off where my cursor is, hit enter, it's back off. I want it on. Turn on, select the third type. What I mean by that is here's six different plots that this thing can make. This one kind of looks like a histogram. That's the one we're trying to do. So go over and highlight that third one. Note the first one's highlighted, third one's where my cursor is, hit enter, and now it says, all right, you want a histogram. Tell it where your data is. What I mean by that is it's going to default to say my data is in L1. Suppose it wasn't in L1, suppose it was in L3. Well, then I'd hit L3 here. I'd highlight it and hit second and then 3. L3 pops up. But I don't want L3. My data is in L1, so I'm going to hit second. And then 1 and L1, put that back there. Maybe I'll say leave frequency alone. Leave freak 1. Just leave that alone. It's a default. That is what you want. Now you're done. Step 3 is, so now your calculator can make this, but we need to specify the viewing window. Um, You can skip this step by going under the zoom menu, but then your calculator kind of guesses how big you want your histogram to be, guesses how big you want the bins to be. So I recommend hitting window here. So you hit this window key right here. Again, you don't have to exit out of anything. X min is the, you want this to be your left bound for smallest bin. Your X max is your right bound for largest bin. And then your X scale is the bin length. So what I mean by that is I want my histogram, it's GPAs, so maybe a reasonable histogram here would be 1.0, 2.0, 3.0, 4.0. But be careful, even though all my data is between 0 and 4, ties go in a higher bin. What I mean by that is someone who has a 1.3 GPA is going to go in this bin for sure between these two. But someone who has a 1.0 GPA is kind of tied between these two bins. They always go up one. So a 1.0 would go in this bin. So similarly, a 4.0 would go in the bin above 4. So the right bound for my largest bin is actually going to be 5 in this example, even though their GPAs they only go up to 4. Weird, I know. So your X minimum should be 0 in this example, and your X maximum should be 5, because this is 0 and this is 5. And your X scale 1, because I wanted each of these bins to have length 1. If I want to make these bins smaller and have the GPAs from 0 to 0.5, 0.499999 to be exact, then I change my scale here to 0.5. But I think I like having them at 1, so I'm going to do that. Y min and Y max, I guess I have a couple more here. Y min. You can always make this 0 or let's say always negative 1. Negative 1 instead of 0, just because I think it's kind of pretty when you have a border around your histogram. So negative 1 kind of gives you a little bit of room underneath the axis. And Y max, I always say a couple more than your than number of observations in the biggest bin, in the bin with the most observations. How can I say that? A couple more than the number of observations in the couple more than the number of observations in bin with most observations. It's probably a better way to say that, but who cares? So I don't know how many observations are in my bin. I bet 10 is safe. That's probably bigger than I need. Actually, I'm almost positive no bins have more than 5 or so. But let's leave it at 10. We can always adjust that. Y scale, Y X res, and Y res. If you zoom down. Oh, there is no Y res. Y scale and X res, just leave those alone. Don't touch those. Step 4 is view. So you can view this thing. All you gotta do is hit the graph key. So if I hit graph over here, bam, my histogram pops up. Pretty nice little histogram. Looks like I have an approximately normal histogram. View, maybe and trace. After you look at it, I mean, it's nice, it's pretty, you can see it, but it's not labeled. I mean, it is labeled based on the scales that we put in that last menu. But this trace key here, graph, then trace, can be really helpful. If you hit this trace key, what it'll do is it'll say, all right, your first bin went from 0 to 1, although it doesn't include 1, that's what this is getting at here. You have to be less than 1. So from 0 to a little bit less than 1, we had 2 observations. So if I wanted to draw a histogram here, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I had 2 in this first one. So something like that. And then you scroll over and it says between 1 and 2, you had 3 observations. Between 2 and 3, you had 7 observations. 5, 6, 7. And so on. 3 and 4, you had 4. I guess I'll finish it up as long as I'm here. And from 4 to less than 5, meaning how many people had a 4.0 in this example, there are exactly 2. So you don't really need the trace feature. You can kind of just try to redraw this shape down here. But I don't know. I think the trace is kind of satisfying. It really describes the data, so it's a good thing to look at. But I think that's about it. That gives you a decent idea of how to view, look at, create a histogram with the TI-83.